This solution will allow you to quickly make a customizable rotation and translation animation like the one you see on the screen. In the corner, I'll leave you a link to my website where you can download this script, import it, and now we see how to configure it. In the hierarchy, select the game object to which you want to apply the animation, click on Add Component and find the script. It's called Rotation Translation Animation. Enter the play mode to see how the parameters in the inspector affect the animation. First, you want to set the rotation axis. In this case, the local vertical axis is the Z axis. Then in inspector, I select the Z axis. I increase the rotation speed a little bit, and for the vertical movement, the script uses a sine function. So here you can modify the amplitude and frequency of the sine wave. If we want the vertical movement to be more pronounced, we increase the amplitude. If we want it to be faster, we increase the frequency. We can also make this object rotate on the vertical axis, but with a certain angle. For that, we will have to create an empty object, make sure that it's in the same position as this object. For that, I'm gonna copy here the transformation, gonna paste it to this object, and I'm going to clean the rotation and the scale. All 0 for the rotation, and all 1s for the scale. Then this way, we have a game object that is located in the same position as the car in this case. We put the car object as a child of the empty game object. I'm going to remove the script from the car and assign it to the empty game object. And now I rotate the car object a little bit. In this case, the vertical axis is the Y axis. I increase the rotation speed, the amplitude, the frequency, and enter in the play mode. Now we see that the object is rotating around the vertical axis, but it has some inclination. You can also offset the object from the rotation center and achieve an effect like this. That's all I wanted to show you, hope you find it useful, and see you next time.